Alright guys, how we doing YouTube? Figured I do a little review about my EOTech 557. Don't see some people complaining about it, some people not complaining about it. The reason why I see some people complaining about it, what I've heard and read on the reticle, a lot of people don't like, let's get this up close here, these three dots right here, that's what it looks like. Me personally, I don't mind it. I actually like it. I'll show, I'll turn it on and show you through the camera, but it really doesn't do it justice. It really doesn't. But the, like, you know, the first dot up here is 0 to 300, second 400 meters, third 500 meters, and the sixth is your elevation for 600 meters out. I like it. I really do like it. It's not that bad. A lot of people say it's all blurry. It's real fuzzy. You can't tell. But on mine, when you're right up on it and it's real nice and bright, the thing looks great. I love it and I don't mind it at all. So with that, here it is. And this is the 557. I like it's got this notch right here. You got a flat top like I have here in my AR. You can put this to the very, very front. And then this will fit over your Picatinny rail. This will slide right over. You can fit it to your very, very front. On my Rock River here, I have a Troy battle sight that I use it for, and it fits right behind it just fine. And there's actually quite a bit of room back there. So that's not a big deal. I do like that little thing they did. On the side here, you have your elevation and your windage that you can adjust. There's nothing on the back. So if you want to get a three-time magnification, which I don't have, but I do plan on getting, you don't have to worry about pushing your buttons. This is it right here. You have night vision. This is your up and down to turn your brightness up, to turn your brightness down, and to turn it on. Now this one right here on the right side, if you push this button to turn it on, it'll stay on for 8 hours and then it'll shut itself off. If you push the button on the left, the down arrow, it'll stay on for 4 hours and then shut off. If you want to turn it off before then, you push both of them at the same time and it'll turn off. Now I didn't get I got the little turn level here, not one of those, you know, latch levers. I think this was a little bit cheaper if I remember correctly, guys. And quite honestly, I don't mind it at all. This thing screws on great. I mean, you get a good tight snug on it, and this thing doesn't move at all. It's really that good. Right here's where your batteries go. You got this little lever here, this little latch. Pull it up, slide this off. That's all you got to do. I think it takes two AA batteries. Real quick and easy. If you feel right here, that's rubber. It really, there's rubber here, and there's a rubber seal right here. So this is waterproof. And slide that back on and see, and it's pretty tough right there, and then it clamps down. There's a good seal there. There's no water is going to get in there at all, none at all. Okay, let me turn this on and see if I can get y'all a decent picture of this reticle. I don't know how it's going to work out. Okay, I turned it pretty bright. Let's see if we can't see this here. Get it off that box. Actually, let's turn this light off, see if it helps out. There we go. Now that's pretty bright. I got it way bright for y'all, just try to see it. This camera does not do this optic justice. It doesn't. It's not all blurry the way it looks in the camera here. Let me try to turn this down. Okay, see that a little bit better? You can start to see that line right there in the middle. Still yet, the camera does not do this justice at all. Seeing how far that goes down to nothing. Turn it back up. And all you gotta do is hold the button. You don't have to keep pressing, press. Hold the button and it'll come up just fine. I like it. I really do love this. This thing works great. See how that... I can't wait till I get my three-time magnification to go with this. And you really should get a close-up. And like I said, to turn it off, see if I can do this. Take both your fingers, push them together. Bam, off it goes. Great site, guys. There's two sites that I really like. EOTech and Trigicon. I love Trigicon ACOG, but I am a poor mofo and can't afford almost a $1,000 ACOG. This was about $550. The magnification is probably going to be another $550. I just can't afford it all at once. Can't do it. So I'm going to come back over here and turn my light back on. And let me show you what I was talking about. I don't know if you can see this in the camera or not. There's your flat top. And you can slide it right on the front there. And if you wanted to have your little guards or anything, you could put it further up, further back. And with that little notch right there, see how it sits down? If they didn't put that notch in there, you couldn't scoot it as far forward as you want to. You'd have to move it back a lot, and then you wouldn't have all this room back here. Because back here, I have my Troy battle sight, and it fits just fine behind it. So, that's about it, guys. If you got any questions, if I missed something, or you want me to clarify a little bit better, just let me know. Please subscribe, and have a good day. Enjoy yourselves.